الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. The German philosopher Arthur Schopenhauer said, "All truth passes through three stages. First, it is ridiculed. Second, it is violently opposed. Third, it is accepted as being self-evident." And this is the stages the message of Islam went through. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, family, his clan, his tribe, Quraysh, they denied him. They ridiculed him. They labeled him as mad, as a sick, as crazy. And they tortured his followers and killed some of them. They boycotted the Muslims, and they pushed them to the mountain and blockaded them there. No business, no marrying from them, and eventually they conspired to kill the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Why is this reaction from Quraysh to the message of Islam, which is very simple, very pure, and very true? They have more than one reason, but the most important is economic. With this, the holy Kaaba and the Masjid, they were able, through the 4 months where fighting is prohibited in the Masjid and around the Kaaba, all the tribes would come there and worship their own gods, which were encouraged through the idols, and they consider them as intermediary between them and God. They had certain rules, like al-Humus, where the people who come for pilgrimage, they're supposed to buy special clean new clothes from Quraysh, or they have to do the rituals naked. And they had a lot of business going on in several markets like Ukaz and Dhul Mijanna and Dhul Majaz. The second reason is one of the most dangerous of the cardinal sins, the pride and jealousy. We can see this in Abu Jahl, whom we talked about being very wise. His name was Abu al-Hakam, the wise one. He was good looking, handsome, and aristocratic. He came from Bani Makhzum. And Bani Makhzum is a branch of Quraysh, a little bit far from Qusay and his children, Abdi Manaf, Abdi Dar, and Bani Umayyah, and all of those who are closer cousins. Makhzum is the son of Yaqaza, the son of Murrah, while the rest of Quraysh are coming down from Qusay ibn Kilab ibn Murrah. And we have said that Makhzum or Bani Makhzum used to have the weapons and the war equipments, so they were, and the horses, so they were kind of powerful. Abu Jahl was preparing himself to become the king of Arabia, and here comes this orphan, and he see that he sabotaged everything for him. And he gave his logic to Quraysh why he is opposing Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his message. Not, he doesn't know him that he is telling the truth, because he knew him, As-Sadiq al-Amin, the truthful, the trustworthy. And his logic was like this: تنازعنا نحن وبنو عبد مناف الشرف. We competed, and Bani Abdi Manaf, the other branch, the honor and the prestige. أطعموا فأطعمنا. They fed the multitudes, and we fed the multitudes. وحملوا فحملنا. They gave support and transportation, and we did the same. وأعطوا فأعطينا. And they gave in charity and help, and we did the same. حتى إذا تحاذينا على الركب وكنا كفرسي رهان قالوا منا نبي يأتيه الوحي من السماء. So we were in neck to neck competition, nose to nose, like two horses running, and now they come, Bani Abdi Manaf, and say, we have a prophet from us, from among us, with revelation coming from heaven. فمتى ندرك هذا? How can we, Bani Makhzum, bring a prophet and revelation from heaven? والله لا نؤمن به أبدا ولا نصدقه. He's swearing by God that they will not believe in him and will not accept his message.